Hello all of you beautiful people, Jules here for WhatCulture.com. I think it's fair to say that when it comes to video games, as a medium, they're designed around escapism. You can leave behind the doldrums of your day-to-day and instead engage in some unadulterated fighting and fantasy. Here you can play as mighty heroes going forth in the name of good. Why is the game telling me that I need to kill these civilians in order to progress? That does not seem on the agenda, friends. And indeed makes up the examples of this list. As I'm Jules, this is WhatCulture.com, and these are 10 video games that forced you to be cruel. Number 10, Shaming an Uruk-hai, Middle-earth Shadow of War. The beasts and baddies of the Lord of the Rings universe may indeed be a rather horrible lot, threatening to either kill you or eat you at any given moment, or indeed both when meat is indeed back on the menu. However, it still feels pretty horrible each and every time that you're given the option to shame one of these rampaging rotters in the fantastic Shadow of War title. Now, shaming in this sense sees our pair of heroes dominate the mind of one of their defeated Uruk-hai enemies in such a manner that it quite literally obliterates their brain and lowers their rank by 5 or by 10 with some rather naughty and nifty upgrades. However, when the other options available to you involve turning the former enemy into an ally, it becomes very, very questionable as to why you'd want to perform such a horrible action, especially seeing as it leaves the victim in an almost catatonic or indeed deranged state. Hell, if you do it enough times, you can quite literally zombify an enemy. So why would you commit such a cruel act? Well, mainly because in the first instance, the game forces you to use this power. Unable to progress by any other means, you have to literally break the will of an Uruk captain known as Bruz, and the game even notes this as being a fate worse than death. Horrifying and unavoidably cruel. Number 9, Breaking Up Emmett's Relationship, Back to the Future. There may be no crueler aspect of human existence than to deprive another person of love, as after all, it's these types of personal bond that allow brilliance to flourish and for true happiness to be achieved. However, the Back to the Future video game series turned you from a doe-eyed Cupid into an emotional hitman as it tasked you with actively breaking up a relationship between Doc Brown and Edna, a young reporter that he met way back in the 1930s. Now, to be clear, there is a very good reason for breaking up this relationship, as it turns out that Edna prevents Doc from exploring a career in science and even uses his vast intellect to create a totalitarian society with her at the very top. However, that still doesn't stop the act of getting Marty to sabotage their relationship in several different ways, a very cruel act. Thankfully, his actions prevent the world from coming under Edna's heel, but at the same time, it leaves Doc heartbroken for many years, turning to science as a means of burying his emotional side. Number 8, Tranquility Lane, Fallout 3. So this scenario sees the player trapped in a virtual reality simulation as they then try to free their father from the hold of that same false reality. They soon find out that one of the members in this is able to kill and resurrect other people that are trapped inside, and is doing so just to pass the time. Pretty horrible, right? Well, it's about to get worse, as this nutcase then asks us to help out with their experiments. What follows is a series of escalating examples of cruelty, beginning with you bullying a child, then moving to break up a marriage, and finally killing everyone in town. Now, a lot of you will be pointing out that you can indeed activate a failsafe that bypasses all of this horror by enacting a mercy kill on the inhabitants, murdering them once and for all and freeing them from this cycle of torture. However, if you actually look at what happens when you enact this kill switch, it's equally cruel and indeed horrible. You see, by going down this route, the program loads in a group of Chinese commandos to murder everyone in the community, and the last time that I checked, the definition of mercy definitely wasn't being gunned down while you're trying to protect your family. For Christ's sake, some of the civilians try to fight back. It's horrible to witness, and because you're trapped inside until you make a decision either way, it's a haunting scenario to be forced through. Number 7, Locking a Claustrophobic in a Closet, Grim Fandango. No man should ever be locked up in such a small, dark place. These are the exasperated words of Raoul the Waiter, an NPC from the almighty puzzler Grim Fandango. Or maybe he should actually be called Raoul the Waiter and Victim of Your Abuse. You see, in order to progress in the game, Manny, who is of course controlled by the player, is forced to lock this guy inside a pantry while he's getting some wine for a client. Now, this is pretty nefarious, but on a grand scale of things, it's not too bad, right? Well, unfortunately, Raoul suffers from claustrophobia, a very nasty fear of enclosed spaces, and as such, his time inside the pantry might well be a bloody prison sentence. Luckily, and I use lucky rather loosely here, his panicked hammering of the door causes an object to land on his head and knock him out, thus saving him from the panic attack he was clearly having. Manny clearly has no qualms about any of this, but the experience was so traumatizing that Raoul vows to quit because he can never look at that pantry again. Brutal. Number 6. Persecuting an innocent woman. Ace Attorney, Justice for All. The Ace Attorney games have always been about putting the player in the shoes of justice, or to be more specific, a series of lawyers looking to make sure that the truth does indeed come out. In the fourth case of the brilliantly underrated Ace Attorney Justice for All, you're presented with the murder of a TV show actor, and it's pretty obvious to everyone around that the fellow actor, Matt On Guard, is the guilty party. Problem is that you're actually defending this man, and you're doing so under duress because a mysterious assassin has kidnapped your friend and assistant Maya. Therefore, you have to try your damnedest to buy as much time as possible in order for the police to track down Maya's whereabouts. What this translates to is actively persecuting an innocent and mentally unstable woman. It's a horrible and painfully drawn-out trial in which you attack her with evidence that shakes the poor woman to her core, even though you know it's not her. At certain points, the jury even boos you, highlighting how awful this experience is. Yet, you've got no choice, and even less chance to yell, "Objection!" Number 5. Human Puzzle Sacrifice. God of War. Now, the God of War series has never really shied away from a bit of the old ultra-violence and basically uses the underlying current of pure rage and aggression to carry its narrative through from start to finish. However, most of these acts are somewhat justifiable. After all, it's the gods and their respective followers that have doomed portions of humanity and indeed cost Kratos all that he held dear. Yet sometimes the God of War himself can just be a plain old dick for no reason whatsoever, and the player has no choice but to help him express this rather nasty side. Take, for example, the absolutely abysmal scene in which Kratos must enter the Temple of Pandora and finds the way to be blocked. Figuring that he needs a sacrifice in order to proceed, Kratos lowers a soldier who is trapped in a cage, and instead of freeing him, drags the cage in a painfully slow manner up a ramp and towards a fire trap. The man inside pleads for his life, asking Kratos to free him so that they can both return to Athens, and then desperately tries to free himself. Yet for all of his struggles, he's merely burned to death, having served as a glorified key to the temple doors. It's quite shocking how dragged out this section is, and in no way paints Kratos or the player in a positive light. Number 4. Killing a Baby Dinosaur. Conker's Bad Fur Day. If there's one thing that pretty much is at the top of the holy hell, that's pretty dark list, it's killing a baby. Therefore, it's pretty unsurprising that many games don't allow you to commit such a horrible act. Yet Conker's Bad Fur Day is not your typical title, and doesn't just offer up a way to brutalize a babby, but also makes it mandatory. In the chapter Ooga Booga, Conker has to make an offering to the dinosaur god that inhabits this lava-filled level. Yet before you start thumbing through the wallet to see if it will accept expired subway vouchers, this is a debt that has to be paid in blood. Enter the cutesy little dino baby, which hatches and imprints onto Conker, and who is then led back through the level to a ritual site. And when I say ritual site, it's basically a platform with a massive stone slab hanging above it that with one well-placed rock comes hurtling down and squishes our poor baby dinosaur. What makes this so horrible is the fact that not only is the dinosaur cute as heck, but it even helps you out by eating enemies on the way back through the level. And what does Conker do? He just sits back and says, "This is gonna be interesting." What a monster. Number 3. So many Mario Maker levels. Super Mario Maker franchise. Nintendo, what were you thinking? In giving the world the ability to make their own Mario levels, the Super Mario Maker franchise unleashed a new wave of torture upon the world, so much so that some of these stages should be considered bloody war crimes. However, in amidst all of the brutally challenging platforming that would see even tool-assisted speedrunner software sweat, is an absolute horror show of cruelty. As you can posit any of Mario's cute little helper friends, including the iconic Yoshi, into any of the levels, some true sadists have used the poor creature as either a mechanism for making otherwise impossible jumps, or just to torment the player by inadvertently killing them with their actions. These levels force you to walk through hell and cast down your allies into the fiery pits, making Mario out to be one of the coldest bastards out there. Number 2. Winning a Crown. Fall Guys. It's been well documented by now, even despite its relatively short tenure in the gaming industry, that Fall Guys is a game made by bastards for bastards, who clearly want to drive a wedge between you and all of your friends at every given opportunity. This is because the game boils down to survival of the sh**. fittest, aka who can outlast and indeed betray their way to victory and claim that elusive crown at the end of things. This means that even if you party up with three other friends in a group, time will come for you to turn your back on your friends and stab them in theirs. Whether it's stealing another person's tail at the last second, forcing them off ledges or into obstacles, or running along hexes to deplete their movement options, you basically become a horrible person without even meaning to, as at the end of the day, they're going to do the exact same thing to you. So while Fall Guys looks like butter wouldn't melt on the outside, just below the surface is a raging inferno. And number 1, literal torture, Grand Theft Auto 5. The Grand Theft Auto series has often posited players into the morally questionable moccasins of some out-and-out arseholes across its time, and as such has meant that it's quite impossible to complete missions with a truly clear conscience. However, there's mass murder and chaining explosions together for the fun of things, and then there's quite literal torture, which rears its rather ugly head in the mission by the book in Grand Theft Auto 5. Here the player is tasked with extracting information from a suspect, but thanks to the tools at your disposal, you can extract teeth and part of your soul as well. This section rightly received backlash for its graphic depiction of waterboarding and other torture, but seeing as GTA lives off of controversy, this only invoked more people to play it. It's a horrifying section for sure, and definitely challenged the player's perception of where the line of violence in video games as entertainment should be drawn, if at all, but the fact that it forced players to use such terrible means sure left a sour taste in many a mouth. And there we go, my friends, those were 10 video games that forced you to be cruel. I hope that you enjoyed that, and please let me know what you thought about it down in the comments section below. As always, I've been Jules. You can go follow me over on Twitter at RetroJ with a 0, or you can swing by Live and Let's Dice, that's Dice with a C, where I do all of my streaming outside of work, and it'd be great to see you over there, my friends. But before I go, today we detailed a lot about video game cruelty, but my friend, you should not be cruel to yourself. Don't beat yourself up for mistakes in the past. You are a good person. You deserve love, happiness, and respect. Never forget that, my friend, okay? And do not let anything or anyone else tell you otherwise. You're a massive ledge. Now go out there and smash it. As always, I've been Jules. You have been awesome, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye.